There are still some concerns out there where people believe that there might be issues with either fertility or pregnancy when you get the COVID-19 vaccine. It's really important to know that many studies have shown there really isn't any concern in both of those arenas. First of all, fertility. One of the things that we know is in the clinical trials for both Pfizer and Moderna, these are about 45,000 person trials, everybody was told not to attempt to become pregnant. That was the rule for being in the clinical trial. So they were told you need to make sure you use protection, you're not supposed to try to have a baby. Do you know how many babies were born in the clinical trials? 16 babies were born in the control arm. 16 babies were born in the experimental arm with the vaccine. So there's really good evidence that people can conceive just fine with the vaccine. Remember, the vaccine does not leave your arm. It gets injected into your arm and it sits there. And then the cells of your body take it up into the cells, and it's those cells that produce the antibodies. And it's those antibodies that flow through your system, through your blood. And that is why it's actually so protective in pregnancy. Remember, unfortunately, pregnancy is a state that a lot of viruses tend to be more severe, and that is also true for COVID-19. We want to protect our pregnant individuals around the world. It's important to know that we have a registry that's been set up. You can look it up under CDC Safe Pregnancy, and you'll see that there have been over 150,000 pregnant people who have gotten the vaccine and have agreed to be part of that registry to let people know how their pregnancy is going and how their babies that are born are safe and healthy. It's important to know that, again, the one thing that crosses the placental barrier is not the vaccine. The vaccine, remember, is very short-lived. It doesn't last very long in your body. What lasts for the duration are the antibodies that are produced. Pregnant mothers give their baby the safest things. Your antibodies cross through the placenta, and your baby has the ability to be protected once it's born. If you're unvaccinated and that baby is born, they have no protection against COVID-19. If you're vaccinated, you have given them your antibodies. Those antibodies will last for 2 to 3 months unless you breastfeed. Then it'll last even longer. It'll last 2 to 3 months from the time you stop breastfeeding. This is a critical way to protect a newborn baby. Even the vaccines that are underway that will likely be authorized over the mid-winter or early 2022 season are likely not going to protect in that first 6 months of life. So pregnant people can really protect their children by being vaccinated and passing on antibodies to protect them during that highly vulnerable period.